Alright, this is going to be a lesson for Tears Don't Fall by Bullet for My Valentine. It's going to be the acoustic version, and it's in drop C tuning, so you can go on and find the theory online. I just listened to a YouTube kind of online tuner. It plucks the strings and you kind of tune to them, and then fine-tune it to the song. So anyway, like I said, drop C, and yeah, it's kind of a acoustically, it's a very much a two-part or two-guitar song, because the verse part kind of starts off strummed and then it goes to picking. Well, he picks one part and another guy's picking another part down here. So I'll show you. I'm not that good at the picking part of it, but I can show you what he's doing. So to start off, we're gonna play your 6, 5, and 4 strings on your 3rd fret. It's just my dog, and you're gonna play that for one measure. And then you're going to come on your 5th fret 3rd string and your 6th fret 2nd string. And you're going to slide your pinky from your 6th over to your 5th on your 2nd string. And then back. So you start open, on, over, back. And then slide down to your 5th fret on your 6, 5, and 4 strings. Same kind of fingering position here, you're going to be on your 3rd string and your 2nd string on your 7th and 8th fret. Then back to your 3rd fret, top 3 strings. And then come on, like you did before, on your 3rd and 2nd strings, on your 5th and 6th fret, and over. When you come on this time, the 2nd time through, you kind of slides up. And then back. So you end up going from your 5th up to your 7th, right? And you keep these two fingers on your 2nd and 3rd strings, except they'll be on your 9th and 10th fret this time. And then you come back to your 5th fret, and then back to your 3rd fret. So I guess for me, the easiest thing to do would be play along. Comes out of that little chuggy part is going to be your 2nd fret 4th string, sorry, and you're just going to palm mute it back here, and then it's going to come into an A minor, and this is the part he kind of strums it to start, and then he goes from an A minor to an F. So you'd be on your F there, which would be 1st fret 2nd string, 2nd fret 3rd string, and 3rd fret 4th string. And you're going to slide that whole F position up to your 3rd fret. So your index finger there is now on your 3rd fret. And then back to your A minor. Then he does it twice. And then kind of holds that chord. And then he's going to go into the picking part. So, you're going to pick through those same chords. The A minor, the F, and this chord, whatever. We'll call it F2. when you're picking it, if you're going to do this, the first guy's picking, he starts on his 4th string. I don't know if you can see that. 4th string, 3rd string, 2nd string, 3rd string, 1st string, 2nd string, 3rd string, 2nd string. So. And he does the A minor twice. The only thing, the cool thing with this picking pattern is it's the same for all the chords, because then you switch into your F and it's the same thing. 4th string, 3rd string, 2nd string, 3rd string, 1st string, 2nd string, 3rd string, 2nd string. You know, it does that one once, and then he slides it up to this one, and it's the same thing. 4th string, 3rd string, 2nd string, 3rd string, 1st string, 2nd string, 3rd string, 2nd string, and then back to the A minor. And it just keeps repeating that. It's kind of hard to hear it because when he's doing that, the other guy is on his 5th fret 2nd string and his 8th fret 1st string. So he'll always be these two strings, but he moves his finger. Well, it's always going to be your 5th fret. He moves his other finger. So go from your 8th fret, and you're going to start on your 1st string, and pick your first string to your second string and just repeat them back, like that. And then he's going to go to the 10th fret, which is quite a stretch. You might have to put your finger down here on the first fret behind it just to help give yourself some bounce and some power on your baby finger, or however you want to. If you can reach it with that one, feel your roots, I can't. So then it'd be your 10th fret on your first string first, and then your second string. And then your 7th fret. And then back to your 8th fret. Okay, so when you're playing through with the song, it's hard to hear if you're kind of on the right spot or if you're in the right time, because there's all these other notes playing over top of it. And then the chorus is going to come off that part. And the chorus is just like the intro, except there's no sliding over. You just kind of hold it. And then, yeah, so. Slides up, sorry, yeah, it does slide up the same as the other one does, except you're just kind of strumming. Move back into that part. When you're strumming that, it's kind of like. Prominent upstrokes, so it's kind of down, down, up. Down, down, up, up. So the A minor is held up for two, and then these are just kind of one. And then you go into the picking part. And like I said, if you're doing it, you can practice with that picking. I'm not sure how good you'd be at picking it. I find it kind of hard to hear it sometimes and just learned it. So, yeah, pick away at it. And if you need any more help with it, just let me know. It's kind of a pain in the butt. Drop C tune in your guitar. So, anyway, cool. Hope it helps, guys. Check out FYI Guitars.